Hey, everybody, good morning to you. And I've got a great phone call here to talk a little bit about something near and dear to so many people's hearts. It's Christmastown USA, Rachel Hansen on the phone. Good morning.
Good morning, Jeff. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well. And I've been seeing on Facebook a lot of great posts and things are happening in downtown Shelton. Not to the extent that we have seen years gone by. Of course, the parade is not going to happen, but there's still things for folks to safely and socially distance, get involved and get in the holiday spirit. And this weekend is going to kick it off. So what are we looking at? What can we expect this year?
Well, Jeff, there's a lot happening, and as we keep adding to the layers, but I'm really excited to be offering the Christmas tree maze again. Mm-hmm. Last year, we did win the Guinness World Record for the most lit trees in one location. We took down Hallmark Channel. So we had 797 trees in the maze last year, and we have had a dedicated group of people bringing us trees. The chamber worked really hard to get trees from Sierra Pacific and Green Diamond and then Port Blakely, and so we brought a lot of trees down here. They're all trees that were scheduled to be cut down sometime this year, so, and they're beautiful and big. In fact, they were so big that on Monday when we had that wind, the whole maze fell down.
Oh, no.
But, yeah, because the ones for the maze last year, we cut down quite a bit so that we could get the lights on them properly, because that was one of the stipulations of the Guinness record. So, yeah, we have a maze set up. We have some big tents. We're working with the Christmastown Kiwanis. They're the sponsoring group that is posting this, because they usually do the parade and the first night celebrations. Yeah. And historically been doing that. And they came to me and said, hey, we just really want to do something this year. We want to have family fun for the kids and something that's safe. So we worked really hard to come up with a series of COVID safe programs that can get people out of their house, and it can also keep people busy in their house interacting.
Very cool. So First, the tree maze, is it in the same location as last year, or has it been moved?
No, actually, this year we have it at the Mel Chevrolet lot on First Street, and the Mel family has kindly donated the space for us. It's about an acre, so we have lots of room to spread out, and there's parking. And Carrie's Tire is letting us use the power from there, so we kind of ran a wire over there so we can have the maze on every night for people. So we'll have it on a timer so people can come even when the actual events are closed.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, it's right down on the main street on First.
And then you mentioned some things that folks can do at home. How does that work?
Well, this one's been a real challenge, but it's been really exciting. We've gotten some amazing donations from the Martha Reed Foundation, the Shelton Rotary, and just people donating just like $100, $50. And what we've done with that money is we've gone out and organized 100 packets of crafts. So we've gotten all the supplies you need to create a really cool craft. We're working with some of the same crafters we had last year. And the people can pick up their packet either at the maze on the weekend, because we're open Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, or they can pick it up during the week at the chamber on Railroad Avenue, and they just take their packet home, and they can sign up to join a live crafting Zoom, and we'll all make them together, so the whole family can sit down with a crafting packet. It has everything you need, and we'll make it together, and there's no charge, because we've had so many people donate stuff. So,
oh, man.
That's one of the things we're doing. The other thing is, next week we're going to host our second annual gingerbread challenge. And we're going to have the gingerbreads on display down Railroad Avenue, so people can bring them in anytime from 8:30 till 5, from the 7th to the 11th of December. They drop them off at the Mason County Chamber office on Railroad Avenue, and there's no fee to do that either, but we have a really amazing gingerbread sponsorship from Dr. Bauer's office, as well as the Windermere Real Estate. So we have cash prizes for people pretty much in every category. So it's kind of exciting.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm. So where can people go on Facebook, or go to Christmastown Kiwanis Facebook page, or is there some other websites?
The best place to go is a website we set up for this event. It shows all the people who are sponsoring it. We keep adding to it every day because people keep showing up with to be treetop sponsors. And we have, it's called Christmastown WA, so ChristmastownWA.org. And the other big thing we added two nights ago, which is basically almost sold out. We only have one ride left. is our dinner wagon train, where we're trying to support the local restaurants who are obviously having a little bit of a challenge right now with not being able to have a dining room. So we're taking the Christmastown wagon. People, we've divided into two dining areas with a solid partition down the middle, and we have two dining areas for a family of five each, or a group of five each, and you can pre-register for that. And what we do is you board the train, we have music playing, you're being towed by one of Tozer's tractors, they've donated a tractor for the whole month, and you go up to the restaurant of your choice that you picked, and they serve your dinner curbside, and then you drive around and you get to look at all the beautiful Christmas lights in the wagon. You can have your blankets, you can be cozy, you can listen to music, and then we take you back to then drop you off at the maze. So that's been really amazing. Two days we've just about pulled out.
That's really cool. What a fun one there. I'm on the site, ChristmastownWA.org, and again, we'll put the links to that here on this and on our Facebook and website as well. You know, I see, too, that Christmastown Kiwanis shared our parade coverage from last year. We'll probably put that on the website again. I mean, it's not the same, but whatever we can do, I guess, to bring back the spirit as best we can. It's a tough, fun, rewarding project, I'm sure. You do so much for the community, and I know everybody really appreciates it. Did you think, I mean, that you had to, I'm sure, make a lot of adjustments by the time we get
to... It's really just trying to anticipate what will happen. We've had some Boy Scout troop is volunteering to have monitors at the door so we can check our numbers. The maze, the queen of the forest is Grace Raniker is actually coordinating all the volunteers to make sure that we have people watching all the entrances. We keep our numbers right. We're going to have fire pits set up, and we have enough of them so that we can have just a family group around each one. I mean, just little things like, before last year when we did this, we had roasted marshmallows, and we're like, well, we can't trade sticks around. Mm-hmm. So this year we found, and it took us a long time to find them, but skewers that are like over 3 feet long, and it's like no touch. You take your stick, you take your marshmallow. When you're finished, throw the stick in the fire.
Oh, yeah.
So it's been a lot of planning. The Christmastown Kiwanis, I've just been working tirelessly on this to try help mitigate things. One of the other things we're doing, which I'm really excited about, is because, you know, some of the members of Christmastown, they're not really interested. They want to be able to participate, but they maybe don't want to be in a live event because we'll be open on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Mm-hmm. So they're doing, if people sign up on the website they want to send letters to their kids from Santa Claus. And you can send us your children's address, a little bit about them. And the ladies from the yacht club are going to respond to them personally. And the shopper has donated the amazing handcrafted Christmas cards, and they've donated tons of signage. But the cards, I'm just so excited about, because imagine getting that letter from Santa Claus that is personally made to you from someone in Christmastown. I mean, it's just kind of a beautiful thing, really.
That is. I see that right under the Things to Do tab. You'll be able to click there as well as get information on all that we've been talking about. It's going to be it's going to be a lot of fun, and it's going to be as, you know, what we can do to get through the holidays and make it as festive as possible. And I'm really excited to see how much the community has stepped up. And I know a lot of people, you know, as with distance, are going to be coming down and seeing all that you and the Christmastown Kiwanis and everybody, PUD, putting the lights up around town and all the great folks making Christmastown another great success. Rachel, it's always good to talk with you.
Thanks, Jeff. Thanks for having me.
And we'll check in down the road. And man, just looking forward to some fun events.
Thank you. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.